Hello and welcome to this mountain flight episode of Erze Shim with the black snapper, which you see here. A great platform with brushless gimbal, NASA V2, and around 12 to 15 minutes of flight time. And the ability to tilt up, which gives you new possibilities in filming, or tilt down while ascending. And it also gives you absolutely jello-free videos. Film such interesting things like this Windrad, like this wind turbine. So this flight took place on the Teichalm in Styria. But here I was on the Sommeralm, and later I show you the Plankugel. So this is the Sommeralm. And the ability to look down makes really nice option. And you can follow things like cars quite easily. And it cuts through the air really nice and smooth. A lot of hikers were up on this hill because it was great weather. And also some parachute guys. I'm not sure what they did there. They tested out their parachute, I guess, but they didn't have enough wind to get it in the air. Here I'm trying to circle ourselves, which takes some practice, but it looks cool. And as always, I had a good camera woman with me to capture those nice impressions. This is the start for the second flight, a few hundred meters from the first start, where there were these great bumpy little fields. And here I was heading to the summit, the Plankugel, which is 250 meters away from where I started. And it gave me an awesome view here. And I got some attention from these hikers here. And I really love to look down while overflying some objects. Yeah, and some breathtaking scenery here. Now you can circle objects like this summit's cross, and even when flying sidewards you get straight image because the GoPro is held straight by the brushless gimbal.
120 meters sind jetzt gerade.
220 meters to the cross. They took photos of me. Now here I wave, but you can't see it because the camera works against my waving. You have seen it in the shadow maybe. Yeah, and that's the flight back from the cross to here we sat down on the right. And the wind turbine we were on the previous flight. I love this shot. So even though the wind turbine turns, it wasn't really windy or gusty, it was rather constant breeze, which was nice. It gave me smooth flying times there. I tried to look down while flying over these bumps, but the field is going upwards, so you couldn't have flown long without crashing somewhere. Again, some spinning around and winking or waving. Here already some audience gathered around. One last look around in the scenery before my timer goes off, which beeps at around 12 minutes, and that gives me enough room to land within the safety margin of my batteries. I could fly 15 minutes, but 12 minutes with some powerful flying, it's at the 20-25% mark, where you shouldn't unload a battery much more. Yeah, this was the approach to the landing from the first flight, and I kind of like how the ending shot worked. Wasn't really planned, but yeah, could tilt up and have this nice shot. Yeah, this is the audience that gathered after the second flight. You can see even the walking is stabilized. Great.
The video camera holds sich selber gerade.
He already saw me on the spot up the summit.
Jetzt macht halt nicht verwackelte Videos. Und ich kann ein bisschen oben schauen.
Explaining how it works.
Und das kann man alles da steuern. Also das Obi schauen und so, oder?
Genau, ja. Und das macht er selber halt. Wahnsinn, so weit, dass er gerade halt.
Und das haben sie selber gebaut?
Zusammengebaut, ja, aber das kriegt man.
Okay, so hope you enjoyed it. A little extra long flight. Make sure to subscribe and come back every week. Thanks for watching. Bye.